I'm Bill Gates, chairman of Microsoft. In this video, you're going to see the future.
In the late 90s, we were sort of the bad guys, the Death Star.
They were in the middle of the Justice Department monopoly issue.
Disruption was coming from all sides.
They said our new PlayStation, so powerful, that's going to replace the PC.
Sony was showing a slide at trade shows and to our customers of a future home that was full of PlayStations and didn't have any PCs in it.
When Sony unveiled the PlayStation 2, they started talking about how they were going to be the death of the PC.
You don't enter a market and copy what the competition does exactly. You enter a market to disrupt it, to do stuff they can't do with Windows and DirectX. We have the platform that everybody wants to do the work on to make the games. We already have the entire infrastructure of everything you need to create all this technology sitting on our platform.
We started to do some acquisitions, and we were growing our publishing business.
The console business was something that we needed to seize. I think that that was where Bill and Steve realized that they needed to move forward with Xbox.
Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy, Archangel Nexus, and I'm back once again with another episode of Madness Gaming. Before we begin, don't forget to hit that bell, click like and subscribe, you know all that good stuff. So,
what do you guys want to talk about?
Let's talk about that state of play. Because I remember when the media got even a little bit of a wind that Microsoft would be putting their games on PC. They sounded all of the death bells for Xbox. They were like, it's done. There is no point in buying an Xbox. Why would I buy an Xbox if all of their games are going to be on PC? Right? You remember.
Oh my gosh. What do I do?
But here's the thing. If we go back in gaming history like I did in the beginning, you guys saw that video? You saw. Ever since the beginning, Microsoft wanted to make absolutely sure that PC kept control of the living room because Sony was about to make a push. They really convinced themselves that they were going to kill PC, and there was a slim chance that they were going to partner with your cable companies to do it. But the Microsoft team got together. They fought to create this thing that was essentially supposed to bridge the gap between the living room and the PC and turn the PC into the spot for gaming and take advantage of the console market, bringing a new concept to the industry that hadn't been done before. Seamus Blackley himself even said, there's no point in getting into the gaming industry if you're not going to get in doing something different to disrupt it. And where are we now?
Fuck. Sorry, Major.
You've seen that state of play. You've heard everything Sony's been saying.
But I have to take your key.
Their games are going to PC, all of them. But the difference here is that the goal for Microsoft was always PC from day one. So let me share some figures with you. 1 billion PC gamers. And after that state of play, I'm pretty sure that number's gone way up. 3 billion mobile gamers. Because mobile's taken over every bedroom. And yet, when you go to consoles, you see these weird fluctuations. You see that the figures have not grown since the PS2 era. It's still bouncing around 200 million and 50 million. Half of PS4's audience hasn't left to go to PS5. And there's a chance that those figures didn't upgrade because they went to PC. And if you look at the figures for Helldivers 2, it looks like that might be the case. It seems as if half of PlayStation's audience has already gone to PC. So you ask yourself, why is the media ringing a death bell on Xbox? The console's always moved in the direction of wherever technology was really going. And consoles have never stayed the same. They've always changed forms. And ever since Windows 95, PC has become a lot more console friendly, with a lot more console features. And with Xbox looming in the horizon, with the possibility of having Windows on board, it's going to have Steam. And with Steam comes PlayStation. All of PlayStation. The whole slate. But I think it's kind of weird that you got this media giant, all these little media groups that are now bought by IGN. They were all saying this whole time that just Xbox was going down. But here's the thing, that's mostly been an algorithmic type of thing. Whatever news is the most popular is the one that is seen most often, and that's the news that is believed to be true most often. But when you dig deeper past the, oh my god, the Xbox house is burning down, is that Sony's been showing us shipped figures for so long that we started to buy into the idea that those joints was actually being turned on by people. Developers were convinced, the media was convinced, the algorithm was convinced, and every casual that looked at the news was convinced. But nobody saw what was happening in the wider gaming industry. Nobody took mobile seriously. That platform went from a million to a billion to now it's 3 billion, and it's probably going to be 4 billion in not that much time. If it ain't already at 4. Because I don't really know what the real figures are. I know that I've seen Sarah Bond say that gaming as a whole is an audience of 3 billion at least. Gaming, gamers, all of us together. Now here's the thing that I thought it was kind of sad, because I know I've been gone for a while and I haven't commented on a lot of shit. But what I think is sad is that when you look at console figures versus the wider gaming industry, PC and mobile, when you look at the numbers that those platforms are doing in engagement and in units purchased, you compare it to the console space and it's like, why are we just talking about the death of Xbox? And then why are we talking about that in light of multi-platform gaming? All of gaming, for the most part, is multi-platform gaming. Your PC is just your PC. It's not like everybody else's. It's your unique creation. Even if you bought a bunch of copies of other people's, you're going to customize that shit and make it into your own. So each one is separate. And there are billions in the entire world. And yet the media is so focused on just the 30 million people that are buying consoles, that are buying console games. Because when you think about it, if consoles are at 200 million, but exclusives are not even really going that anywhere near that high, you got to think that either the console market is fractured into small audiences that are not a monolith, which makes perfect sense if you look at the single player's average sales for single player games. The budgets have ballooned beyond the capability of the audience to keep up. And what have Xbox gamers been saying this whole time? We've been saying that games is going to be games as a service and multiplat. We didn't see it as anything wrong. But some people saw it as that there was something wrong.
He's not happy. Let's hear what he's not happy about.
I hate this. I fucking hate live service, bro. Like, this is why. This is why I feel like I'm losing my interest in gaming. Because it's literally coming down to, if we don't get people literally fucking drug addict addicted to this game, then we're not fucking making it. Then we're not supporting it. This has to be drugs, bro. Like, fuck you, and fuck your live service, and fuck this shit, because I'm tired of it. I'm tired of it. Like, this is what's ruining gaming. I'm fucking tired of every time I boot up my fucking PlayStation, the top 10 most played games, Fortnite, Call of Duty, fucking FIFA. Like, get the fuck out of my face with that shit, man. Yeah, I am pissed.
At Sea of Thieves, that shit, bitch.
I am pissed. And how sad is it that I'm literally out here, I'm raging about live. It's like we've elevated to another status here. Where it's not even, I'm not even bitching about live service. I'm bitching about live service games not even being good enough to be released. Like, what in the actual fuck is going on in this gaming industry, bro? This is the shit that makes me jaded. This is why I'm jaded. This is why I'm pissed off. Fuck. This is not what, like, I did not expect this. I can't help it. I'm trying so hard to walk the path of peace, man.
What?
Are those tears? Or please cry. Oh, wait.
No, he cried.
Unfortunately, they don't get the business. If you're going to be a developer and you want to make a really amazing single-player game, you need to fund it. And if you can create something that people will play for a lot of hours and invest in a lot of digital currencies and outfits and downloadables and all that good stuff, then you can use the money from that to create your dream game. Some companies decided that they were going to make games the other way around, where they were just going to dump money into a developer and create the most beautiful thing people has ever seen. And when those games didn't keep up in engagement versus how many they shipped, those games fell. Those developers fell with them. Hi-Fi Rush was an amazing game. It deserved a lot better. And I was very disappointed to find out that the PlayStation community didn't treat that game well still. Which sucks, because now they're gone. But we see a lot of PlayStation YouTubers talking about how that's Xbox's fault. That Tango is gone. I don't know about that. Because I've been talking about it for a long time before this happened. I've been talking about how developers are falling because gamers are walking away. PlayStation gamers, you guys had... Well, first of all, we're all console gamers, right? I'm an Xbox gamer, you're a PlayStation gamer, we got Nintendo gamers. We're all console gamers. Remember, PC gaming is a different audience. Some of us are part of that audience, like me. And some of us are part of the mobile audience too, like me. Mobile's at 3 billion, PC's at 1 billion. Us console gamers, the people that still appreciate console, what were we doing when we should have been elevating our devs? What were we doing? We're tearing them down. For clout, for views, for clicks on our silly little overreaction articles about the death of this or that. When you really think about it, what console gamers should have been doing, we should have been celebrating our developers. Because now, PlayStation exclusivity is dead along with Xbox exclusivity. And it's your fault. I said it in a past video that if we don't appreciate what we got, it's gonna go away. And what we got doing? I remember early on Hi-Fi's release when it was about to come out on Game Pass on Instagram, there were a lot of comments about how Hi-Fi Rush was live service trash.
Fuck you and fuck your live service and fuck this shit because I'm tired of it.
Many people didn't invest their time or their attention towards that game off the bat without even having touched it. Just because it was on Game Pass. And here's the thing. Hi-Fi Rush was the easiest layup we've ever had as a gaming community. If we ever wanted to prove to the industry, this is what we want. I played it. A lot of my friends played it. But there's an audience out there that didn't, specifically because it was on Game Pass, not even because it was anything bad. And they didn't give it 2 seconds. And that's the audience that I blame for Tango going away. I'm not happy that they went away. I'm actually ashamed that that happened. I'm disappointed in our community. I wish that Hi-Fi Rush would have had access to the Switch off the bat, you know, if that was going to happen. Because the thing with Tango is that they were already burning down. their best people walked away from the studio the second they got the money. So it was like not many people left with the passion to keep this vision going that they didn't even have in the first place. Like, this was some, they were working with somebody. They signed on to work with somebody on their vision. They didn't sign on to be abandoned with it. We've seen that happen multiple times. We've seen that happen with WWE 2K when the main team left and they left behind the shell. And 2K kept on and it was messed up for a while. A lot of devs don't want to go through that. They just see it as, forget it, I don't want to do it. So, they sadly closed down the studio and they absorbed, hey, if you guys want to keep making those games, work with us. And then someday when you're ready, you can go back to Hi-Fi. Because it's still a Microsoft property. They didn't... Hi-Fi's on the shelf, you feel me? It's not gone. The studio's gone because the developer's gone. That's what he wanted for his life. He wanted to take the bag and run. Shit. Who wouldn't? You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. You know, they're not gonna get on his ass about it. They're just gonna be like, hey, if that's what you want, cool. But hey, we got the game on the market, right? And after that, whose responsibility was it? It was ours. And you PlayStation gamers that claim to have powerful PCs that you didn't need an Xbox, right? Where were y'all? We know there's at least 200 million of you that claim to have bought PlayStations, right? Unless you really believe that those are shipped figures between the three PlayStation generations from PS3 to PS5, right? That's the only way, which means that we're not talking about people. There's no point. Those are shipped. There's dudes that walked into stores, bought a bunch of them, put in their garage, wanted to sell them shits on eBay. That's sold through. That counts. And we don't know who was who. We just don't. Because that's not how it works. Somebody walks into a store, buys a PlayStation, you don't know if they're going to use it. That's why Square felt abandoned. Because they thought there was people out there really turning these joys on, that y'all was really going to buy their games. And you know what? When Microsoft made the FTC deal, they was told, look, you need to put these games on other platforms and honor the existing contract. So whatever dev had a PlayStation version, they was going to honor that. They was going to release it. And they was going to release something to show that they stick to their word. Because they needed that ABK dude. They wanted that shit. They could taste it. They had grown Call of Duty on the PC for years. To lose that to anybody? Nah, that was not going to happen. And the tech industry was sniffing around. And I'm not talking about PlayStation, I'm talking about the real tech industry, the trillion-dollar companies that, like Amazon, the Amazons and shit, like the Googles, like they're sniffing around. I would rather have gaming fall into Microsoft hands than none, trust me. Because they've been there since the beginning. You don't want some outsider that ain't never been part of the gaming industry. You want people that's been a part of the gaming industry, trust me. So see, anybody talking about how things on the Microsoft Xbox and is going anywhere bad is not smart. But we should have rallied behind these devs. Because look at how big the other platform, look at how big PC is, look at how big mobile is. Together, we were supposed to have elevated consoles to new heights. We were supposed to have telling people, yeah, buy a Switch, buy a PlayStation, buy an Xbox. But instead, PlayStation games were tearing it down. And it turned out they were tearing down themselves. And the platform wound up with a state of play that looked a lot like an Xbox show. That's the shit that was crazy. When I saw those games, I was like, wow, this looks like some games as a service shit. This looks like some multi-platform shit. And remember, on Twitter, on YouTube, we heard that PlayStation was never going to put their games on other platforms, ever. Not on PC, ever. That was the very first thing PlayStation gamers said. You saw it. I don't even need to show it on this channel because so many people have seen it. But the goal was to take over the console business, and that's exactly what Microsoft put PC in the position to do, and they did. Now every PlayStation game, every Xbox game is on the PC. And Nintendo's already starting to talk about them, you know, the prices of making games, you know, like they already talking about it. So you heard it from other people. You've heard it from PlayStation, you heard it from Xbox and every big company in the gaming industry. You heard it. So when Nintendo's starting to talk about that, I don't know, man. Napkins are starting to look expensive. They're going to start thinking about other platforms as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if they push onto mobile and become a multi-platform platform as well. I know that don't make no sense, multi-platform platform, but you know what I'm talking about. We've been talking about it for years that Microsoft has not been doing nothing wrong. They've just been ahead of people, and people are uncomfortable with that. People like their comfort zone. PlayStation single-player games are like comfort food, you feel me? But they're expensive for the developers. They take a lot of time, and there ain't enough of us to make them worth it without a backup plan. And PlayStation went in hard with the single-player games. They went in so hard that they didn't really grow their online ecosystem, so they tried to co-opt the Call of Duty ecosystem, the Fortnite ecosystem, those audiences, like, hey, we got games, come play it on our platform. And it didn't work, because people that play Fortnite mostly just play Fortnite, and people that play Call of Duty mostly play Call of Duty. So it didn't work for them, because it didn't translate into the single player games. Their single player games sold a lot. They didn't sell enough for like factions to survive, even though they sold you the multiplayer at launch. That's the shit that's crazy.
Man, this is some bullshit. Boo this man.
Something that they sold you at launch, they couldn't even deliver on. They told you it was coming. You paid for it. Then they left it out the remasters on purpose, because they knew. They knew they was never going to come out with that shit. And you stayed waiting for it. But what did you do? You foamed up, right? Foam up. This is a great time, because I watched that state of play and I was excited, because I'm like, hey, I could play all these shits. I don't need a PS5. Now I'm wondering, like, where are all the articles about the death of PlayStation, right? Because we just saw the death of PlayStation exclusivity. I'm pretty sure they're going to have, like, some single-player titles that they're going to try and be stingy with for a little bit. But it's all going to PC, and PC Steam is coming to Xbox. All your base are belong to us. That it is what it is. Microsoft wanted to take over console gaming, and they did. You saw in the clips that I put. That was the mission from day one. Mission accomplished. It's over. Sony lost the console war. The war was never about who sold the most consoles. Remember that. The war was ecosystem. Windows has been an ecosystem virus since the beginning, and it's infected almost everything. And their competition is not Sony. Their competition is Google, it's Android. It's iOS. It's those bootleg phones that's coming out all the time with, you know, different versions of Android on. That's the competition. And right now, if the console business wants to survive, it needs to combine. All those PlayStation gamers that was dumping on Xbox One for what it did, now y'all look stupid. Welcome to games as a service. You're late. Sit down. Take the fucking headphones off. Shut the fuck up. Learn. You just got here when PS3 came out and you didn't even learn shit. You didn't learn shit the whole time. Now sit down and shut up. You wouldn't be crying in your podcast if you didn't invest 10 years of yourself into something that was never true. You bought into shipped. Let's just say it right here. Everybody bought into shipped, and no one took engagement seriously. Mobile was smoking everybody in engagement. PC was smoking everybody in engagement. But console gamers was fighting over shipped. Y'all stupid. Xbox gamers was telling you, look, man, this is the future. They're not doing nothing wrong. Y'all always online right now. Right now, you are always online. When the media was looking at them with them crazy looks, like, what do you mean always online? Microsoft was looking at you like, what do you mean? You got a cell phone in your pocket. Shut the fuck up. And they stuck with it. They kept pushing services, subscriptions. They kept pushing it because they knew the future was not in the bullshit people was holding on to since they got in the gaming industry. Watch Power On just the first episode and you'll see that they knew where they were going the whole time. PlayStation fanboys, y'all fell for it. That's why you're crying about State of Play. Because you really thought that shit was always going to be like that. Now Sony's talking about, oh, we're coming out with one really big tentpole title a year every holiday. I said it before, the PlayStation engine has stalled because they didn't get into games as a service early enough. They went in backwards. Microsoft went in, look, mobile's killing it with microtransactions. We're going to have to go in with shit with backdoor incomes if we're going to be doing big budget games. And that, and people's wondering, like, well, how are all these developers succeeding on Xbox and surviving? And why are you closing down this guy over that guy? And it's because those games are healthy. They have a healthy business model. They work. You can dump on them all you want. I played the shit out of Halo Infinite. It's a great game. Played the shit out of Starfield. Great game. People play the fuck out of Forza all the time. Like, they're gonna blow gears up. They're gonna play that shit. They're gonna play it religiously. Those are great games. Sea of Thieves, look at that. Killing it on PlayStation with the audience that shed on it when it first came out. Imagine if that dev didn't survive. You wouldn't be playing nothing right now. Imagine. Because you're not playing Helldivers. PC, the PC audience is playing Helldivers. And Square had to divorce from PlayStation because they needed to see other people. And it's like they tried to get in a committed relationship with PlayStation. You know, it's not like they've always been exclusive to anybody. You know, they see Nintendo a little more often than everybody else, but, you know, they tried to get into this relationship with PlayStation permanently, and what happened? PlayStation lied about how much it got. Fuck. That's why Microsoft was like, yo, we switching to engagement, because you can't really tell who's out there for us with the shit bullshit. Stores are closing down all the time. Malls are closing down all the time. Shit don't mean nothing no more. Stores don't want to hold on to these consoles no more. Stores are closing down. You know, back in the day, consoles were like, what, 30% of Toys R Us's business? Nintendo had a stranglehold on Toys R Us. Now look at Toys R Us. It's gone. Look at all the other stores, gone. All those places that Sony used to ship to, gone. So where they ship to? They ship to places they never shipped to before. Countries they don't have PSN. And what happened? Those people didn't want to make an account? Nah, they couldn't. They cut out a whole part of their entire base because they jumped too soon. And people was wondering, why isn't Microsoft in more places? Well, do I have to say? That's why. Because the infrastructure ain't there. But mobile is. And this is where, you know, $3 billion is a threat. If your budget's ballooning past the 200 million people that may or may not be out there on your console platform, you gotta expand. So,
here we are again.
Goodbye PlayStation exclusivity. Is that... It is what it is. Now, if you want to say Xbox is dead because exclusivity is dead, PlayStation is dead because exclusivity is dead. But these things don't matter. Their platforms are bigger than the console. They're bigger than exclusivity. You feel me? PlayStation's bigger than PlayStation. You feel me? Like, it's a brand people recognize everywhere. Xbox is bigger. I mean, Xbox is fucking huge. It's all over PC. Now it's going to be all over mobile. $3 billion. Microsoft has both feet on mobile now. They got both feet in the mobile water. Call of Duty is one of the biggest mobile games in the world, and they own so many. It's not even just Call of Duty. This is crazy shit. So Microsoft is on billions of platforms already. I agree, they should have kept Tango open somehow. Maybe put a new a new face behind the brand, you know? Maybe they could have worked with this person and kept going, but look, I'm pretty sure smarter people have already had this conversation to death, and it was what it was. I'm sad too. I don't want to see none of these people go. But when I'm looking for a finger to point, they gave it to the console market leader, and you still fumbled the ball. And this is your type of game. But I guess these ain't your types of games no more. And that's why Sony came out with the kind of state of play they did. Because it turns out the online people are not really the people that they're looking for. Our audience is smaller. So when you talk about all these PlayStation fanboys talking about what the best games in the world are, they lied to y'all. There are bigger platforms that have more people playing games that they think are the best games. And you ignored them for too long, and now you're paying the price. I'm looking forward to Microsoft's next show, and I'm looking forward to the next Xbox consoles. I'm looking forward to all the games they got coming, because everything is looking great. They're spread out nice and even. They got games for every audience. Things that people worked on for a while, because we saw how long it took them to get the games out. And now the engine is finally getting to speed. It's reaching that 88 miles power that we all talked about. And we about to go into the future. That's what's happening. I like the state of play. I'm going to probably play some of those games. But let's keep it 100. I'm excited about Xbox. And I don't give a fuck about who ain't. I'm excited about Game Pass. I'm excited about having all of my games in one place. From every platform. I already have it on my Steam Deck, but not really. Like, you know, it doesn't really feel the same without the Xbox Dash. You feel me? Like, the Xbox experience. I'm looking forward to that handheld. Because that handheld is going to open all the doors that used to be closed for Xbox. And we are going to become one with PC. And I think that's the thing that Sony was afraid of the most. But they're going to benefit from in the end. This is what the thing, all the fear-mongering people were doing. Oh, this is the death of Xbox. Not the death, they're growing. Oh, this is going to be the death of PlayStation. They're growing. Whether or not that grows console sales is not relevant anymore. You're part of that audience until that audience withers away into nothing. And they're probably going to change the what a console is by then. You feel me? Because consoles has never been the same forever. We've had different types of consoles. Someday the console might be this little bitty USB that you can Bluetooth with your controller. You feel me? And your console is in the cloud. Is this device you're playing off of through a connection? One day, that's where we're going. It might be no box at all because shit just runs good. Why do you need anything? It might be that some of us still want it. It don't matter. It might be that consoles turn into PCs, and that's basically what they're about to do. Anyway, they've been a PC since shit. Y'all heard my other videos. You know what I had on my OG Xbox? I had Linux on that shit. That shit was a PC to me. I had everything on there. PlayStation, Nintendo, Xbox. So for me, it's already been like that. So I wouldn't be surprised if consoles just turn completely into PCs and whoever don't goes away. Winds up being a brand somewhere in an app, or maybe everybody becomes an app. I don't care. I'm playing the games. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. I know it took a little while. I just needed to get that out. Shout out to my peoples. Demoflow Gaming, On Point for Gamers, Dirt, and Sean. I love y'all guys' podcast. Gerson Zero, and Dean. My boy, Escape to Gaming. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. We're going to get up out of here. Later.